start. To tell about myself, I did my schooling at Government Girls High Secondary School and I pursued my college at Imperial College of Engineering Technology, which is affiliated to Anna University. And I am 2014 passed out student. I do have 1 year of experience at ERA Technologies, and where I work as a data annotator and Java developer. After that, due to Corona, I lost my job. So everyone, if they lost their career, for sure they will be choose their passion. And I do have passion over teaching. I choose teaching line where I can contribute my knowledge and skill to the kids. After that, today the topic we are going to cover is Pythagoras theorem, and it is only applicable for right-angled triangle only. So why we are calling it as Pythagoras theorem is because it is found out by the Greek mathematician whose name is Pythagoras. So as he found out this theorem, we are calling this same theorem using his name. And we see what is Pythagoras theorem today. Okay, see, we'll see first what is a right-angled triangle. In any triangle, okay, in any triangle, if any angle of an triangle is 90 degree, then the triangle is meant to be right angle triangle. And the length side of that angle is hypotenuse, which is opposite to 90 degree. And this is underside, base side, right? So we are calling it as base, and this one is perpendicular, which is perpendicular to in this 90 degree. Okay. What Pythagoras theorem clearly states is that the square of two sides is equal to the longer side of a right angle triangle. So that means AC square is always equal to sum of square of other two sides. So perpendicular, that is AB. AB square plus base, BC. Base square. This is what Pythagoras theorem clearly states. And where are these Pythagoras theorem applicable is, first one is when we don't know the triangle, what kind of triangle is that. If you want to find out whether the triangle, given triangle is right angle triangle, by that time we can use Pythagoras theorem to find given triangle is right angle triangle or not. In the same, if you know any two sides and we don't know any one side of a right angle triangle, by that time we can use this Pythagoras theorem. So to find any one side of a triangle when we know two sides and we don't know only one side, by the time we can use this application. And third one is, we don't know a diagonal of a square or rectangle, we will be use the Pythagoras theorem to find out the diagonal of rectangular square. Okay, so this Pythagoras theorem is used in day to day. We will see with an example how we will. See, there are two buildings. Consider there are two buildings in a, and we know the height of this building. Okay, and height of this building also, and distance between these two buildings. But what will be the difference between these two buildings? By that case, we can use this triangle. We can use this theorem. How we will be using this? See, we find this distance and this marking like this, and this difference also we used to know that. So here that form a right angle triangle which gives 90 degree over here, right? By that time we will be using this Pythagoras theorem. So today the summary is, in Pythagoras theorem, the hypotenuse square, which is longer side of a right angle triangle, is square is always equal to the square sum of squares of other two sides. Okay, and one more thing, what are the applications we have seen is to find whether the given triangle is right angle triangle or not. And if we know any two sides of a right angle triangle and we don't know any one side of a triangle, by the time we will be implementing this theorem. And another one is to find out the diagonal of a square or a rectangle. We will be, and we have seen that example. Just it is a simple example. And that's it about Pythagoras theorem. Thank you. Bye.